This is Renuka, and I'm a wedding planner. I'm also a wedding designer. And this is my first YouTube channel and my first videos. And this video is all about my brides who are gonna get married soon. This is all about some, you know, designing quirky stuff. My whole videos and my whole channels are gonna be basically focusing on how to make some DIY accessories for brides and new bridesmaids, and also for grooms. So today I'm gonna start doing Kolhapuri Chappals, which is very easy, super easy, super comfortable. And if you dress it with some patialas or something, it's a super easy and super quick to make. So I'm gonna show you the process from this to this. For this, we will require a fabric, and make sure that your fabric is easy to make some creases. And if you don't get some fabric like that, you can even use tulle, which is basically your knit fabric. And you can always match it with the dress that you are wearing. So you can choose to go contrast. If you're wearing some yellow, go for orange or pink. Or if you're wearing some pink, you can go for glittery, some gold or shimmery look fabric. So here we need a fabric. So I've already cut this. The size is around 11 by 8 inches, and this is around 1.5 to 4 or 4.5 inches. And apart from this, we will also require a glitter sheet and a glitter loose, so it's in a liquid form. And we need a cutting tool. I'll also use scissors and my cutting knife. So because I already have these footwears, my Kolhapuri Chappals, which are actually old, and I thought I'm gonna give them a new look. So what I did is, like, I just took off this bow, and so I'm gonna do the same with this one also. I'm just gonna take this off using my tool, and now we're gonna start the process, and I'll keep these aside for now, and I'll show you how we make bow. So firstly, I'm gonna fold this into halves. Make sure your both the sides are equal, and then I'm again gonna repeat the process towards this side. Make a pocket kind of a thing, and then you just have to keep on going back and forth, like this. I am done, and this is like coming out. So what we'll do is, we will now keep this aside, and we will use this, and we will fold it, make a crease. And so actually, now that we know how COVID-19 is going around the world and people are sitting at home, I think this is the best time if you have postponed it your wedding, because yeah, in my field, that's the make sure you have been hearing about this, that people are postponing their wedding. But yeah, I request you, if you're planning to cancel it, don't cancel it, just postpone it. And by then you can try these DIYs at home, and you can try making these for your bridesmaids also, and even for your grooms also. Like, you can make it for your groom, write some quirky letters or something. So that's it. Now I'm gonna just use my needle, and I'm gonna just make like few stitches, like 2 or 3 I'll be doing. Make sure you do it from the sides or on the bottom, so that's not visible. Also, if you don't know how to use needles, you can always use hot glue gun, which is also easy to do it. But I know that it's mostly available with all those crafters, so you might not be having it. If you have, that's good. And I would not advise you to go out at this time, because I'm totally using all the DIY things which I had at my home, and I'm just trying to reuse all those things. I didn't go out and purchase on any of these things. So it would be good if you just use anything which is available at your home. So So now what we need to do is I'm going to take my old Kolhapuri chappal and I am going to use my super glue for this. I'm going to apply a bit of it on this. Make sure you use this very carefully because if it spills on all over your Kolhapuri, it might spoil the texture of your footwear. So make sure you use it in a very proper way, not too much. Even if you're not gonna be a bridesmaid or you just wanna, you know, give some really stylish look to your footwear, to your old footwear basically, so you can just always make these bows and put it on your Kolhapuri or shoes maybe, or maybe you can make a hairband out of it, or take a plain hairband and just make this bow and go all flashy and quirky. So now that we're done with this, I'm gonna use my glitter sheet because that's when we're gonna do the alphabets. So in this one, if you see, I have not sticked it because this glitter sheet is basically comes, it's a stick. So for writing over these glitter sheets, your pencils might not work on it, it won't be visible. So use a marker or something in a black color, so which will help you in cutting it properly. So I'm gonna write Sassy Bride. So right, Sassy. And now, using my paper cutter, I'm gonna cut this. We have S, R, A, then again S, and S, and Y. So if you find it difficult in cutting these sheets, what you can do is, you know, we already get these alphabets in the glitter sheets as well. But those are a bit costly, and in a sheet you will just get like A to Z or A to 01 till 10. But the thing is, those alphabets might not be repetitive, and you might have few words, whatever you want to write in your footwears, they might be like some repetitive words. Like if I'm writing Sassy, it's like it has three S's, so you won't get those S's, you will just get one S in a sheet. So, and this sheet is around say 30 rupees or something, I got it, and so. What you can do is, it is always better if you want to use more of the alphabet, you can just write it on your own in this stickers sheet, and you can cut it properly with using this paper cutter. So now that I have Sassy and my bride, so I am gonna keep this aside. I'm gonna fix this now. What I'm gonna do is, these words were not for not this, I'm gonna fix it now. And for fixing these, I'm not gonna use my super glue because this might spoil my fabric. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna use my fabricol or my fabric glue. and it was supposed to like be a bit pure. Then close my eye. Keep pressing it towards your fabric so that it gets stuck on the fabric. Right, so it's there. I'm gonna write sassy on the other one. Then my last outfit goes sassy. I'm gonna leave them for drying for some time. And so, if you like my video, do like and subscribe to my channel. So I'm gonna post more videos which are gonna be DIYs for basically the bride's accessories. If you want, you can go and try the same thing on your shoes. Also, you can paint your canvas and use these glitters and just write some alphabets using your paintbrush. And if you are not able to follow any of these steps, you can always DM me, or you can just follow me on Instagram. You can put all your queries there, and I'll get back to you. Hope you like the video. Thanks for watching.